Hi, welcome back to my channel. Happy Friday. I have my front door open, which is over in that direction. It is currently cloudy outside, but hopefully it's bright enough that you can see the planters in front of you. Bruce is doing okay. He had his third treatment on Tuesday. He has a rare skin cancer, and his oncologist is hopeful that we can put this into clinical remission. So fingers crossed that he can do that, that will happen. So in front of you, I have my A5 HON inside this leather cover. This is the Cousin, also A5. This is what it looks like now, almost nearing the end of April. And then this is his planner, his journal. This is the A6 Hobonichi. I did an updated version because I added this, which is his meal log, where I've been keeping track of his meal. Since he started chemo, he's lost some weight. And the reason why I'm pulling this in too is the fact that if you look at this, you can see that I'm feeding him quite a bit in one day to try to help him gain his weight back. But also his kibble is pretty big. And so compared to the smaller kibble that I used to feed him, he needs more food to make up for the smaller kibble. I think that's part of the reason why, besides the chemo, that he lost weight. Was the difference between the smaller kibble versus the bigger kibble. And it was something that I spoke with his oncologist about, and she agreed that I should feed him a little bit more. But I decided to break down how many times I feed him in a day, and then keep track of the amount that I'm feeding him. And then as you can see, I'm writing it down. So again, 4.5 cups. Sound like a lot of dog food, big kibbles. The oncologist is fine with it, so I will keep doing that until we get him back to the weight that we need to get him back to, which is his normal, like over 50 pounds weight. So my cousin, let me show you this one first. So this is my daily devotional. This is the standard traveler's notebook. In here, I keep track of my meals, and this has been going great. So this is how it's looking so far. My weight is in the colored column, and then my steps are in the non-colored column. And then the little stars are the days that I charge my step tracker, which is right there. And as I always say, I may not get accurate steps, but at least it gives me a general idea of how many steps I am taking. So here I keep track of my sleep, and that's been going well. I've been trying to get back into exercising, starting with my arm weights, as well as squats with the weights, and I only did it twice this week. If I remember, I'm gonna try and do it today. Down here is what I call my mean time, where I've been trying to keep track of taking better care of myself. And then over here is my meals, and then I keep track of my vitamins. I like to keep track of my breakfast, lunch, dinner, and snacks. And then here's my HON. I've been using this as my writer's notebook. I have not been able to really focus on writing so much. This is the monthly layout. So these are just really functional appointments that I need to be able to see at a glance what is happening for the month. Now let's jump to the week. So this is what my week looks like. Packages over here. And then I really like the Minion washi tape, which I picked up from the 99-cent store a long time ago, which is probably like last year or the year before. But I just thought it was really cute, so I decided to put him back down and use them. This is the week before, and then the week before that. So where this is really functional, now I will show you my cousin. So where this was really functional, this is slightly prettier with more stickers and washi tape. This is from the Cookie Monster Co. And where last week I was trying out, since I'm trying to get back into gardening, so every day instead of putting down a sticker when I'm in the garden or doing something garden related or houseplant related, I decided to try and just put one sticker down here and then create a row. Today's Friday. Packages are also over here. So you can see, so this was has been working really well. And then I don't have to use this gardening sticker so many times on the pages like this. Instead, I can look to see what I did on any given day. So this is last Friday. And then here's Bruce feeling halfway decent. This is Saturday. Sunday, so here's the Hobonichi paper. And I put pictures underneath of my mom with my siblings. But you can see how it's like a little book page. And then this is some curtain rods that we bought. I didn't want to lose it, so I decided to tape it down so that in case I want to buy another one to have it match the other window, I know where to look and I know where it is. This is a dish that my mom used to make when I was a kid. My mom is doing as well as expected. She is still in a home, like a rehabilitation facility. She had a fall back in mid-October, end of October. I think it was October 26th. But she's still there. And so my sister sort of shared this recipe. And I decided to try to make it. And it's missing some jalapeno peppers to make it just a little bit spicier. But it, I thought, came out pretty well. Here's Bruce again. This was on Tuesday when he went on his, we took him to his oncologist for his third chemo treatment. So this is the before. And then here's the after on the bed. And he was looking out the window, or out the door, down the hallway. On Wednesday, he was feeling pretty good. He has not played with any of his toys since we started this. It was nice to see him play with his toys again and get back into his doggy bed, which houses all his toys. So that's why I took the sequence of photos. Over here, this is my mom's loquat tree. She had a tree, so before my parents sold their house, they had their tree back there. So this is the tree from her original tree back at the old house. It fruited, or it started to flower last October. So I was able to show this to my mom, the flower on the tree. The fruit is finally ripening. So in case you like loquat and you have your own tree, just so you know, when it's this color fruit, which is kind of just starting to turn yellow, it's not ripe. I took off two because I couldn't figure out when it was ready. And apparently this is the kind of fruit that needs to stay on the tree to ripen. Otherwise, it doesn't sweeten at all. So I was picking them sort of at this sort of yellow stage. So they weren't ripe. Yesterday, I found some that were a darker kind of orangey yellow. And I tried one. And even though it was slightly watery, it was sweet. So this is the correct color. So I took two photos, unripe, ripe, so that next year I will be able to remind myself when to pick them. So that's why I have that in here. And then here's Bruce, there's me. He was hungry. He was letting me know at hour two that he wanted to eat. And so he was climbing on the couch. We have a two-seater with the, there's like a compartment in the middle, like an armrest. So he was standing on the armrest, watching me, letting me know that he was hungry. So I decided to take that photo. And then here's Friday, which is today. And that is a very quick look of my planners, my Hobonichis. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe if you'd like to see after the pin videos of my planners. I hope you guys have a great weekend. Thank you once again for your well wishes for Bruce. We really do appreciate it. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.